Hello everyone. Thanks for joining this presentation. My name is Pranav. I'm software engineer at Arm. So in the next 20 minutes, I'll be talking about an overview of the server ready and ACS and some of my experience on using the ACS on Arm Neoverse reference design. And at the last part of this presentation, we'll show a set of results which is obtained on Neoverse environment reference design and see some and we'll show some tips on how to debug the failures in ACS test cases. Yeah, so let's start. So server ready. So server ready is actually a compliance program. It's a standard approach for ARM server platforms and which will certify that a server is good to run with standard OS. And in server ready has a set of requirements for both the hardware as well as the boot firmware. And we classify this into two, the SBSA or server-based system architecture or the hardware requirements. And the next part is the server-based boot requirement or SBBR or which contains all the firmware requirements. So this is about server ready. So for getting the complaints, have actually a architecture complaint suite or ACS. And ARM have the server ready specification and the server ready specification has set of requirement. In ACS, actually we have test cases around each of this requirement. So if you look at the ACS test suite, we can classify into two, the SBSA and SBBR or the hardware requirement and the firmware requirement. Again, each of this test case will have two parts and one of the part will be running UEFI shell prompt and the next part will be running the Linux environment. For SBBR also, the test cases are similar. There is a UEFI test case as well as an FWTS or the Linux test cases are there. Yeah, so what are these SBSA and SBBR? So SBSA or the server-based system architecture. Right now, the server-based system architecture is at version 6 and which defines the hardware requirements. As this is a hardware requirement, it classifies the hardware into multiple levels. And right now the hardware levels available are from level 3 to level 6. And these are the criteria for deciding a hardware fall under which level. And yeah, so the SBSA test cases are run for the respective level. And in SBSA, there are test cases for CPU properties and system components like Geek, SMMU, the MMU, watchdogs and timers and like that system components test will be there. And also there will be PCI integration test cases will also be included in the SBSA test case. So as we discussed previously, there are UEFI shell test cases and OS test case. Most of the test cases are covered in the UEFI shell test only, like the CPU properties, system components, and most of the PCI integration test cases are covered in the UEFI part of the test only. In OS SBSA test, there are some minor test cases which are run for the PCI, which need to be run from a Linux environment. So that's an overview on SBSA. Now going to SBBR or server-based boot requirement. Right now, the latest available version of SBBR is version 1.2. Both the SBSA and SBBR is available at developer.arm.com. For specification, please visit developer.arm.com. And in SBBR, it defines the firmware requirements. And in SBBR, we have test cases for UEFI, ACPA, and SMBIOS. So most of the UEFI test cases are covered in the UEFI SCT or the cell certification test. And the rest of the test for ACPA, SMBIOS, and rest of the UEFI test, it's covered into the FWTS or firmware test suite. So this is an overview of SBBR. Yeah, so in the previous slide, we have a understanding on server ready, ACS, and its component like SBSA and SBBR. Now have a look at how to get the ACS test suite and using it. So for getting the ACS test suite, ACS test suite is hosted in GitHub and are open source and licensed under Apache V2. So visit GitHub for ARM ACS and clone the code from GitHub. So once the clone is done, then there will be one script will be downloaded. It is called acssync.sh. So from Linux command line, run the script acssync.sh. So the script will download the necessary packages for building the ACS test suite. And Once the ACS test suite, the source code is downloaded, or the complete source code is downloaded, there will be one build.sh script will be there. Run the build.sh script from command line, which will compile the LAV disk image or Linux UEFA validation disk image. So getting into the disk format. So the ACS disk has two partition. The first partition is used for storing the logs or the test reports. And the second partition contains the bootables and test binaries. So the binaries for testing SBSA test cases, SBBI test cases like that, the binaries will be present in the second partition. Now, for running the test cases, boot the platform with this ACS disk image and make the ACS disk image available to the UEFI BDS stage. Yeah. So these are the steps need to run for running the SBBR test cases. And SBBR, this portion is the SBBR test cases, which is required for the UEFI part. And this part is the FWTS test cases for Linux. These are steps to run FWTS test. We will go in details on each of the steps in the upcoming slides. So moving to next slide. Yeah, so boot the hardware. Yeah, and UEFI, as we discussed the UEFI part of the test cases, we can either run the test cases automatically or we can run the test cases manually. So in this slide, we will discuss both how to run the test cases automatically and the test cases manually. So yeah, running the test cases automatically on boot. For that, boot the platform by making the LAV live image visible in the BDS stage. From the grep prompt, there will be two options will be there, LUV option as well as SBSA/SBBR. So for running the UEFI test, choose the SBBR/SBSA from the grep prompt. So yeah, from the grep prompt, it will again load back to the UEFI. And in EFI, press enter or wait till the timeout of 5 seconds. After this timeout or pressing any key, it will start the startup script for UEFI. And the startup script will launch the ACT test automatically. And in ACT test, there is a provision for skipping the ACT test case. If you need to run the ACT test case, do nothing. The startup.nsh will start the ACT test case. If you need to skip the ACT test case for some reason, then press any key within 7 seconds so that the ACT test cases will be skipped. So this is how we can run the UEFI ACT test automatically on boot. Now, running the test cases so manual running of the test case is also similar. Boot the hardware from the grep, choose the option SBSA/SBBR, and get access to the UEFI shell. And in UEFI shell, identify the partition of the second partition of the live image. So for identifying, the folder structure will be like this. There will be folder EFI, boot, and SBBR. So if this particular path is there, then the respective FSX partition will be mounted with the LAV live image second partition, or the partition of live image contains the bootables. So yeah, now we need to install the SBBR test case. For installing, there is an install.efi file will be there. So run the install.efi file. So it will ask for where to install. So in our case, the LAV live image second partition is mounted at FS3. So the first partition will be obviously mounted at FS2. So we are installing the ACT test into the first partition in the live image. So choosing the option 2 and pressing enter will install the ACT test cases into the FS2 or the first partition of the live image. So once the installation is done successfully, then open the path FS2 ACT. And from this path, the ACT.EFI binary will be there, and run the EFI binary with minus A for all test cases and minus V for verbose into the console. So this is the way of running the UEFI ACT test manually. Now, the next part, SBBR has the Linux part as well. And the Linux part is called firmware test suite. And for firmware test suite, once ACT test is done manually reboot the hardware, from the grep prompt, choose the option LUV instead of what we have done for the UEFI part. So the LUV option will launch the Linux UEFI validation OS or the LAV OS. And once the Linux boot complete, it will automatically launch the test cases present in the LUV OS. So if you look into the D message, it's shown that running FWTS. So this FWTS is a part of the server ready certification. And once the FWTS tests are run, either we can power the hardware off or else we can wait till all the other test cases are complete. So this is the way of running FWTS test or the firmware test suite part of the SBBR. Now moving to running SBSA or hardware tests, or which are the test cases need to be run for hardware. So running SBSA test is also similar like what done for the SBBR UEFA part. So this also has two part, the UEFA part and the Linux part. We'll go through each of this part in detail in the upcoming slides. The SBSA UEFA test can also be run automatically on boot. For that, boot the hardware. From grep prompt, choose the option SBBR/SBSA. So this, after that, the UEFA startup.sh script will start, and the UEFA.startup.nh script will first launch SCT test. And when the SCT test execution is done, then it will launch the SBSA test suite for the UEFA part. Or else the SCT test can be skipped also at this point. Skipping SCT test also will automatically launch the SBSA UEFA part. And if you look at the SBSA, here it is mentioned that starting test for level 4. That means by default in ACS 2.5 is the latest available test suite. And in ACS 2.5, the default level of this SBSA is set as 4. In automatic test case running, we can't change this level. So in manual part, we can change the hardware level as well. So let's see how to run the test manually. For running the test manually also, reboot the system. Then from grep prompt, choose the option SBBR/SBSA. And here there are actually two ways for running the SBSA UEFI application. So in the first method, we can run the SBSA binary and print the logs, print the test result into console, as well as save the same log into a text file. So this is possible only once after running the SCT test case. And the second method is that we can simply run the SBSA.efa binary, and this will dump the result into console actually. It will not save the logs into a log file. So in the running the test case with console log also, we don't have a provision to change the level. But in the second option, actually we are running the SBSA.efa binary. While running this, if we are providing minus L and then the level number, for example, minus L3 or minus L5, which will run the SBSA test for the respective level, for example, level 3 or level 5. So this is how the SBSA UEFA test is run manually from the UEFA shell. So other than that, there is a test case for UEFA Linux also, SBSA Linux also. For running the SBSA Linux test case, once the SBSA, all the UEFA test cases are done, type the command exit to exit from the UEFA shell so that it will again go back to the grep prompt. And from the grep prompt, again choose SBSA/SBBR. So this will boot the Linux OS. And once the Linux boot is complete, once command line is accessible, from command line, simply run the binary SBSA or type SBSA from command line, which will run the SBSA test case and will print the logs into console. So this is how we need to run the SBBR test cases. Yeah, so till now, so far we have discussed on ACS, how to run the test suite. Now let's move to the final part of this presentation, or analyzing of the test results and debugging this issue. So as we told previously, the live image has two partition, and the first partition is used for collecting the logs. And for analyzing the logs, we need to mount the first partition of the live image into a Linux host machine. And if we check into the directory structure inside this, the directory structure will look like this. If FWTS tests are run multiple times, then there will be multiple LU results folder with the date and time when the FWTS tests are run. So choose the proper FWTS test results. And inside that, there will be one file called FWTS. If we open this, it will show all the FWTS logs. So let's have a look at the sample FWTS logs. These logs actually I have collected in NeoWare's reference design, NeoWare's N1 platform. So the FWTS results will look like this. So if we go to the very bottom of this, it will have the consolidated logs. So here, the number of test cases passed, number of test cases failed, number of warnings generated, the skip test cases, all the statistics will be available here. And if for the detailed FWTS test case result, need to go through the entire log file. So this is how an FWTS log will looks like. Going back to the presentation. Yeah, so this is about FWTS, and I'm not showing the SET results right now because there are multiple logs files are there and it will consume more time. So I'm not showing the results right now. So moving to the SBSA results. SBSA results also has two parts, Linux as well as UEFI. Both the results look almost similar. So I am showing the UEFI results for the SBSA. So let's have a quick view of this. Yeah, the SBSA UEFI test case will looks like this. So yeah, if you look at each of the test case will have a number. For the P processing element or the core, the test case starts from number one. And there are test cases for GIC, and the GIC test cases start with number 100, 101. For the timers, so timers and counter, the test case will start with the number two. So with the test case number, we can identify actually to which peripheral component the test case is done. Yeah, and with this, it will be easier to debug the issues as well. So yeah, this is how the test case will look like. And if we go to the bottom, so there will also be a consolidated report. So the total test cases run, number of test cases passed, and number of test cases failed. So it will give the analytics or the complete statistics of the test results. So this will be how the results will looks like. And for a platform to be server ready, there should not be any failures in SBSA as well as SBBR test cases. Yeah, that's a requirement for this server ready certification. Now look into how to debug the ACS issues. So as we told, ACS test cases, there are four parts, two parts for SBSA, two parts for SBBR. And coming to the SBSA part, in SBSA UEFI test case, identify the failed test cases. And the UEFI, the tests are present inside this particular path, inside the test pool folder. And for example, if test case 201 has failed, let's look at the number, it is 201. So the first digit 2 stands for timer test case. So in test pool, navigate to the folder test pool, timer and watchdog test case, and test underscore T for timer, and 001. As it is 201, so we need to choose the 01.c file for analyzing or debugging. For example, if test case 442 has failed, actual test case 444, the first digit is 4 stands for PCI test cases, and the remaining is 42. So the inside test pool, PCI, test P042.c, this file will have the test case for the respective test case. So while start debugging, always start from the payload function inside the test.c. So inside all the test.c, there will be a payload function will be there. For debugging, always start from this particular function. For the SBSA Linux part, the SBSA application will be present inside this path. And there will be a main file will be there, main.c file will be there. So for debugging the Linux failures, always start from the main.c file. Debugging SBBR is also similar. So here also identify the failed test cases. For SCT, the source code will be present inside this path. And for FWTS, the source code will be present inside this path. So this is all about running, testing and debugging the ACS issues. So before ending this presentation, let's have a quick view of running a custom SBSA binary, because running custom SBSA binary is also so important, because SBSA is a first test case we need to validate in a new platform, because these are the hardware requirements. And while using this custom SBSA binary, we can avoid the LUB OS and building all the ACS test cases. So yeah, it's actually lightweight thing. So the first step is to the prerequisite for this is that the user should be aware of the UEFI EDK to build system and how to integrate an application into the EDK to build system. So yeah, for building this, first clone the SBSA ACS application into the local EDK to source code, and once it is cloned, then compile the SBSA.efa application. For before that, we need to integrate the application into the EDK to build system. So refer the GitHub documentation on how to integrate the application, and once integration is done, build the EDK to, and which will generate the SBSA.efi binary, and copy this into a disk partition and boot the hardware by making this SBSA.efi available at the UEFI boot device selection phase. And the rest of the things are same as how we done the SBS in manual case. So this is all about running ACS test case on ARM platforms. Yeah, and any questions? Yeah, if no questions, thanks for your participation in this presentation. Regarding any further queries, please feel free to post them in the LVC20 Slack channel for the event 2.05. Yeah, thank you.